Bonjour, I am Isabelle Arnay, a French freelance illustrator, and I do children's books and book covers and comics. And welcome outside. The sun was really nice, so I decided to take the camera outside for the face cam videos. Today the subject is about both comic and book covers, since a few weeks ago I was commissioned by Tabulit Comics, who asked me to do the cover of their new comic anthology called Fur 2, Feline and Canine, but I'll talk more about this a bit later. So the prompt for this cover was to transform this dog and this cat into two classy business cat and dog for the cover, and they are both the pets of the owner of Tabulit Comics, and they're very cute. After a bit of character designing, I ended up with this sketch that was approved, and I am now going to ink it on the computer. So let's go back inside and check out my tools. I will use Photoshop and my Huion monitor tablet. I have a model from 2 years ago, if I remember right. First, I want to show you the actual speed of my inking. For now, you can see how it actually goes. It takes a lot of time to have a good line, even if I am using the stabilization tool from Photoshop. It's a very good tool, especially for very long curves or line. I'm usually varying the amount of stabilization used. The bigger the line, the more stabilization, and the smaller the line, the less stabilization. As for the brush I am using, it is the most basic round brush there is, with only pressure added. As you can see, the sped up version is way more impressive than the real time, and this is actually, I think, half an hour of work in total. When my lines are ready, I'm doing just a flat layer to separate my character from the background, and I'm just gonna do a small color test to decide on what direction I will be going and if the color pleases me. I decided to go for a neon look, just like City by Night. It's more pop and modern, and I was feeling like it. I thought it was a good idea for this kind of characters. So this is the final line art, and here is the color test I sent to the client. I sent those to the client, and he validated it to me. And once everything was settled, I went back on working on the final color. I actually did not go for a very detailed painting, but rather a graphic one with little to no gradients. I first filled all the area with flat colors and tried to keep the actual resemblance with the inspiration, the cat and dog that inspired the cover, so to have them a little bit more accurate. And then working on the details slowly. Well, rather fast on this video, but you see what I mean. So once I have all my flat colors, I actually start working on the lighting, and I wanted a bold pink lighting from coming from the left that I added with the lasso tool. It's a technique I love and it looks very nice and graphic. Why not go do a full painting, you would ask? I don't know, I'm doing the question myself at this point, but you can add yours in the comment. So why? Because I believe that a nice line work should not be lost under overly complicated volume painting. That's why I do it like that. In the end, I'm just adding a few effects. Actually, I don't know if you noticed, but I ended up not liking the eye of the dog and I changed it towards the end of the painting to have him to give him a more open eyes. I felt it was better like that. And also it made the character more readable from afar. My last step is adding a bit of noise. As you can see, it's a grey I just put right now. It just adds a nice texture to the overall painting effect. Here it is! Fair 2 is currently on Kickstarter, so if you'd like to check out their campaign, I'll put a link under here. I've been around with Tablet for a while now, and I've also taken part in the first fur here, that you can see here, and another comic anthology called Afar. Both are full of really nice comics and illustration, so it's a very good anthology, and both have been successfully funded, so I really hope the third one is funded as well, because there is really nice illustrators this time and comic artists, so let's hope for the best. So I hope you enjoyed this video a bit more about my client work. If you'd like to see more about freelance illustration and how I work as a freelance illustrator, please put a comment under the video. And here is the final illustration. I would also like to thank my patrons on Patreon and also you for watching this video. So thanks a lot and see you next time. Bye. Okay.